Hey guys, and welcome to Youth Online. What's the crack? We hope you're keeping well from wherever you're watching from. You might notice I'm not in my house right now because I really felt like God put something on my heart. And I really think it's important that as we head into youth tonight, I share this, because if it blesses you half as much as it blessed me this week, then that's going to be a great thing for you, great thing for your family, great thing for your mates, great thing for everybody. Right now I'm sitting in one of the local parks near my gaff, and it was funny. I haven't been to this park in years. Most evenings of the week lately, I've been going for a walk for a couple of miles. Fitness freak, you know me. Only joking. And usually I go to a park in Lucan called Griffin. Griffin is a park that's in Lucan. Lucan's where I live. Lucan's also known as the Holy Land, the Promised Land. It's where all the successful and good-looking people live, like me. And I decided, when I saw a sign, I go a different route than I usually go. Decided, you know what, different perspective, different eye on things, and I'm so glad I did. I went on Monday night, and as I was walking, I saw a sign that said Corca Park this way. For those of you who live in West Dublin, you'll know that Corca Park is the park that's in Clondalkin. And I used to live in Clondalkin when I was younger, and then I escaped. Only joking. I moved with my parents to Lucan. But luckily enough, I live close enough that you can walk to that park, but I haven't. Since I was about 7 years old, I haven't been in the park. And I decided I'd go that way. I'd forgotten how nice it was though. I'd forgotten how big it was. I forgot that there was lakes in here, and there's swans in here. There's a fishing area in here. There's a playground in here, and there's acres and acres of land. And I really felt like God was saying to me, Josh, you need to change your perspective. Everybody needs to change their perspectives right now, because your eyes are on the wrong things. Little do you know what's right in front of you and what's been right in front of you this whole time. You know, right now I am sitting at the side of a lake. I am looking at ducks and swans and loads of different things. And let me just show you what I'm looking at. You can see that the lake is behind me, and there's no lakes in Lucan. There's a river, but there's no lakes. And this is just beautiful. And I'd forgotten what was right in front of me. And isn't it funny, we forget what's right in front of us the whole time. And I want to remind you, the good times are in front of you. The times of peace are gonna return. The times of certainty will return, but we can develop something in our lives right now. And as we head into a time of worship tonight, I want to encourage you, the best is right ahead. The best is ahead for your family, for your mates, for your schooling, for college in September if you're in sixth year. The best days are ahead, because God promises that he sees tomorrow. We don't see tomorrow. We can't control yesterday or tomorrow, but we can control today. And my question to you is, what are your eyes on? What's your perspective on? Are you being negative? Well, stop being negative and focus yourself on some positivity. Are you someone who's constantly pessimistic and constantly looks back at yesterday and what went wrong? I want to encourage you. Look to tomorrow. Look to what God has for you today. Tonight, Youth Online, what does God want to say to you? We have a great guest speaker. Phil Rowntree's bringing the word tonight. And I'm so looking forward to what he has to say, because he's somebody who wants to encourage you, motivate you, and bring some good news into your life. So as we head into this time of worship, maybe you're by yourself. Why don't you stand? Why don't you worship? Why don't you sing along? Why don't you hum along? Whatever makes you feel comfortable. Why don't you just refocus yourself and remind yourself of what's right in front of you? Little did I know that one of the most beautiful parks I've ever been to is just around the corner from my house, within 2 kilometers, never mind five. And I really believe that God used this analogy to speak to me, and I hope it speaks to you as well. We'll chat to you straight after worship. God bless.
There's a grace when the heart is under fire. Space between where I used to be and this reckoning, I know I will never be alone. There is another in the fire standing next to me. There was another in the waters holding back the seas. Should I ever need reminding of how I've been saved? A cross that bears the burden where another died for me. There is another in the fire. Oh. stands between us. Nothing stands between us. Oh. And there is no other name but the name that is Jesus. He who was and still is and will be through it. Space between all the things unseen and this reckoning. I know I will never be alone. And I know I will never be alone. There'll be another in the fire standing next to me. There'll be another in the waters holding back. Should I ever need reminding how good you've been to me? I'll count the joy from every battle, 'cause I know that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy from every battle, 'cause I know that's where you'll be. Kindness.
Well, amen, amen, amen. For those of you who are joining us a little bit late, welcome to Youth Online. For those of you who hadn't and were on time, good for you. Welcome to Youth Online as well. We hope that time of worship encouraged you. I'm still in the park and something funny just happened because a big group of teenagers started heading towards me and I got nervous. I'm not even joking. I got nervous and then I realized, wait a second, you work with teenagers. What the heck is up with you? Does anyone remember when you were a kid and you used to go to the park and the teenagers seemed scary to you? Yeah, that kind of happened to me. I'm not gonna lie. You guys kind of scare me. But hey, tonight's gonna be a great night at Youth Online. I wanna let you know a couple of things. Number one, there's no good news guide tomorrow because we want you to be able to catch up on the other episodes. There's some great episodes on there, some on the Word, which is great because we all need to get better at reading the Word. That's with Pastor Sean Larkey. We have episode 2, part 1 and 2 on science and faith. Guys, you need to get that into you because, lads, people care about that stuff. And don't just assume that you know it all because you don't. And we have some great people on. We have Dr. Peter Taylor, Jack Lawless, and it's co-hosted by our very own Danny Bala. And third, sad to say, but this is our second last Youth Online for this season, and then we're going to be switching to something new, which we're going to be announcing next week. So hey, stay in touch with us, hop on Zoom after, and make sure you listen to the good news guide. We have church online this Sunday, 10:30, Facebook, YouTube. We'd love for you to join us. But until then, I'm going to pass it over to Pastor Phil Rowntree, who's going to bring a great word. We hope it encourages you. Have a great night.
I hope everyone's keeping so well. I'm so excited to be with you guys this week. Isn't it incredible that we get to come together every single Friday night and hear what God wants to speak into our lives? It's amazing that we have this community. And I just want to encourage you, keep coming back every single week. Honestly, it's crazy out there at the minute. You need some sanity in your life, and this is where you're going to get it. Let's get around each other every single week and encourage each other and push each other on at this crazy time. Here, listen, I'm just going to share for a couple of minutes. It's a word that God has really put in my heart specifically for you guys this week. And I really believe that God is going to use it to challenge you and to strengthen you and to really encourage you in your walk and in your relationship with Him. But before we get into that quick message, I'd love to just pray with you guys. So Lord Jesus, I just thank you for each person who's watching or listening to this tonight, God. I pray, Lord, that no matter where they are at, God, no matter what they're dealing with, no matter what the week has been like, Lord, I pray that your presence would reach them right now in this moment. And here's the beautiful thing about your presence, God. Your presence knows no bounds. Your presence is not restricted by location. Your presence is not limited by distance, God. But you will reach, and you can reach every single person tonight, no matter how they're feeling, what they're doing, where they are. And I pray that you would remind each of us of your great love for us and the incredible future that you have for us. In Jesus' mighty name. And all of you said, amen. Now, if you said amen loud, your parents are probably like, oh, what's going on? You're on the youth call. It's a good place to be, right? So the title of my message tonight is, this was not part of the plan. This was not part of the plan. And I want to talk a little bit about what we do when stuff happens that is not part of the plan. Now, myself and Ruth, every single summer, we love to go to Spain. We go to the Costa del Sol. We get burnt on day one. And then we spend the next 6 days complaining about getting burnt on day one, even though it was our fault, and rubbing aloe vera all over our backs and all over our bodies. It's amazing. I live for it every single year. And I know it's going to happen every single year, and I still get burnt. But this year is a little bit different. We got to, obviously, mid-May. We'd be used to being in Spain at this time. But instead, we're stuck in West Dublin. And maybe you're like me and you're like, oh yeah, like I was expecting to be in Torremolinos. That was the plan. Or maybe I was expecting to be in Turkey. That was the plan. But you find yourself right now stuck in Blanchardstown, right? It's like that is not Bella Medina, that is Blanchardstown. There's a big difference, right? This was not part of the plan. You were expecting to get your suntan on, girls. You were expecting to get out, put the oil on, get the tan up, but you're still milk bottle white. This was not part of the plan. Get back to the bottle tan. And maybe, fellas, you were like, oh, you know, like I'm really excited to get in the pool and, you know, like show off my ripped abs. Nah, you know, you're going to have to do that in the back garden in Blanchardstown or Ballyfermot. This was not part of the plan. You're not going to get to do it in Spain. And maybe it's a little bit more serious than that. Maybe you've been studying really hard these last few years in school and you were looking forward to absolutely walloping these final exams out of it. And all of a sudden, because of COVID-19, you can't do what you thought you were going to do in terms of education. Or maybe it's the fact that you were starting to get really connected with a group of friends and build some really strong friendships, and you just wanted to hang out with these people in town, and all of a sudden now you can't do that, and you're struggling in terms of your friendships, and you're struggling with thinking what those friendships are going to be like at the end of this crisis. This was not part of the plan for you. Or maybe, you know, you were just starting to get into a really good habit of reading your Bible, and a really good habit of coming into church on a Sunday and youth on a Friday, and all of a sudden this came out of nowhere and it's like a curveball that has thrown you off. This was not part of the plan. And if I'm just being real, there are so many situations in our lives where stuff happens that was not part of our plan. But we serve a God who has a bigger plan than any of the plans that we could ever ask, dream, or imagine in our own strength. And there's numerous stories in the Bible. I just want to talk about one tonight. It's in Acts chapter 28, and it's about this incredible man called Paul. Now, Paul was this guy who was called by God to go into all the world. He went around Europe, around Eastern Europe, around the Middle East, and around Asia, and he declared the word of God. He spoke about Jesus to so many people, and so many churches were started because of him. Now, here's the thing. We see in Acts that God had called Paul to go to Rome. Now, Rome back then was like the NYC. It was like the Big Apple. It was the cultural hub. It was the place where everything was happening. And God had called him to go there and speak to the emperor, like the top dog in all the world, and to share Jesus with him. And Paul was like, here, listen, I'm in. Count me in. This sounds amazing. That was the plan. So Paul, he gets put on this ship, and all of a sudden they're sailing towards Rome. This is all part of the plan. It's going to plan. Let's go. Can't wait to get to Rome. Can't wait to speak to the emperor. Can't wait to talk about Jesus. That's the plan. And then what happens that was not part of his plan was the ship starts to encounter this storm, and this storm absolutely ruins the ship. And all of a sudden, the ship is shipwrecked, and they find themselves holding on to random pieces of wood and floating to the shore of this random island. And it kind of got me thinking of myself in swimming lessons as a kid. You're kind of holding on to the floaty thing, getting to land. You just want to get to land. And he gets to land, and the closer he gets, he's looking out for these big, beautiful buildings. He's looking out for these influential, well-dressed people. He's looking out for the beautiful coastline of Rome. He's looking for the beautiful outline of the skyline of Rome. And all he sees is this random little island. This was not part of Paul's plan. Now, it says in Acts chapter 28, which is where we're going to be reading tonight, that they had landed in a place called Malta. It landed in Malta. Like, oh my word, this was not part of the plan. Acts chapter 28, verses 1 to 5 says this. Now, when they had escaped the shipwreck, they found out that the island was called Malta. So this is not Rome, this is Malta. This is not part of the plan. And the natives showed us unusual kindness, for they kindled a fire and made us all welcome, because of the rain that was falling and because of the cold. But when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and laid them on the fire, a viper came out because of the heat and fastened on his hand. So when the natives saw the creature hanging from his hand, the snake hanging from Paul's hand, they said to one another, no doubt this man is a murderer, whom though he has escaped the sea, justice does not allow him to live. But then Paul shook off the creature into the fire, and he suffered no harm. So here's Paul. He's in a situation that is not part of his plan. He's in Malta. And the first thing that Paul does when he gets to the land, and this is so important for me and for you, is he starts to gather sticks. He starts to get back to basics. Like, you're shipwrecked. You've just floated on this little kind of floaty thing to the shore. What's the first thing you're going to do? I'm going to start a fire. It's the basics. You ask Bear Grylls, he will say, the number one thing is you need a fire. You know, it's always, you need to build a fire. It's like the basics. And Paul starts to collect wood. Paul gets back to the basics of, okay, I need light, I need heat, and I need a place where I can cook food so I do not die. It's a bit like me and you in this moment. We need to get back to the basics of just gathering sticks. We need to get back to the basics of building a fire, which is our relationship with God. Now you're probably asking, well, what are the sticks? I believe there's many sticks in our lives. I believe there's many things that create a bigger fire in our lives. The fire being our relationship with Jesus. There's many things that grow our love for Jesus, our relationship for Jesus. I believe the number one thing is that we know the Word of God. I believe that if we would pick up the stick every single day that is the Word of God and add it to the fire, our fire will not decrease. Our fire will not minimize. Our fire will maximize and expand and increase. So I want to encourage you guys today, get back to basics. Get back to the basics of hopping in the Word of God every single day. Maybe you're like, you know what, I haven't done that in a while. That's okay. You can start today. Get back to the basics of having a regular, quiet, devotional time with God where you open up the Bible, you open up the Bible app, and you hear what God wants to speak to you. Because I promise you, you need light, you need heat, you need a place where you can eat. You need the basics. And if we can collect the sticks, if we can collect the Word of God and add it to the fire, add it to our relationship with God every single day, we will increase and we will grow and we will be safe and we will be secure and we will have light and heat and warmth for our lives. Now, here's the incredible thing. He gets back to basics. He picks up sticks. He adds it to the fire. And it says that as he was adding sticks to the fire, a snake, a viper, bit onto his hand and dug its teeth in. And everyone was watching on and was like, this fella is gone. Like, he's a goner. But the most beautiful thing happens. Paul just shakes off this snake. Paul just shakes it off. So he's building the fire. He's collecting sticks. And isn't it so true that in our lives, whenever you start to get serious about the Word of God, whenever you start to get serious about having a regular quiet time with Jesus, there'll always be someone or something that will start to bite against you. There'll always be a snake that will come against you. There'll always be temptation. There'll always be insecurity. There'll always be fear and doubt. There'll always be questions in your mind. There'll always be people who will say, what are you doing? You're crazy. You're mad. Why are you doing that? There's snakes. There's snakes in our lives that will bite on our hands as we're building the fire of God, the relationship that we have with God in our lives. And I want to encourage you, do not be put off when snakes start to bite when you're building the fire of God in your life. It is all part of the plan. It's always going to happen. They did it to Jesus. They did it to Paul. It will happen to you. When you want to build something for God, when you want to build a regular devotional time with God, and you want to learn a bit about the Bible, oh my word, people will come against you. Situations will come against you. Your own thoughts will come against you. You'll start to think crazy thoughts. I'm telling you, insecurity will bite. You'll start to think, oh, you know, am I good enough? You know, I feel like I'm not giving enough time to God. That's insecurity. That is doubt. There, like, doubt will start to bite on your hand. Doubt of, like, is this even real? Does God even care about me? Am I even important to God? That is doubt. That is a snake of doubt just biting onto your hand. Temptation will start to bite on. Oh, I might just play FIFA with the lads. I might just play Call of Duty again. I might just scroll through Instagram. It will bite on your hand. Distraction will come and opposition will come when you try and build the fire of God in your life. But here's the beautiful thing. Paul shakes off the snake. Paul just shakes it off and it's beautiful. He shakes it off into the fire. And here's the thing, your insecurity, your doubt about whether or not God loves you, whether or not God can use you, when you shake that off into the fire, when you shake it off into that place of your relationship with God, the relationship with God, the fire in your life burns it up and it increases your love for God. It increases your light. It increases your passion. It increases your heat and intensity for God. So I want to encourage you today, shake off the doubt, shake off the insecurity, shake off the fear, shake off the anxiety by getting in the Word of God. And what happens is it will only increase your passion and your love for Jesus. Now, at the end of this story, we can read on, but I don't have time. Paul actually gets to Rome. He gets to where God has called him to go. He gets to the bit that was part of his plan. But on his way to the thing that was part of his plan, he had to stop at Malta. He had to encounter something that was not part of the plan. And I want to encourage you that right now, the situation that you are in is exactly where God would have you. But it's so important that we build and keep building our relationship with God at this moment. Keep picking up the sticks. Keep getting to the Word of God. I want to challenge you practically this week, guys. Try and read a chapter a day. Honestly, start somewhere. Better to start picking up sticks than picking up no sticks. Because if you know one thing about fire, you'll know this. You'll know from camping trips that if you don't put more logs on the fire will eventually stop burning. And we need to be the kind of people, and I believe that you are the kind of person who can say, you know what, I can pick up this stick every day. I can add it to the fire every single day. Monday, add it to the fire. Tuesday, add it to the fire. Wednesday, add it to the fire. Thursday, a snake of insecurity. Fear starts to turn against me. My mind starts to turn against me. You know what? I'm going to shake that off because God has told me his truth and his word, and it's only going to increase my passion for him. So youth, get in the word. I want to challenge you. Get around other people who will encourage you and keep coming back every Friday night, and it will only increase the fire of God, the love for Jesus that you have in your heart. Love you guys. Can't wait to see you soon. And so blessed to be with you tonight. God bless.
Hey guys. Well, we hope that that was encouraging. We hope that that built you up with some good news in the middle of a lot of bad news. And in a couple of minutes, obviously, we're going to be having the crack online on different apps. But it'd be wrong of us to leave this moment and not give you an opportunity to respond. And usually we do this in a big service, but we believe that God is with you right now. And maybe the things that were said this evening are things you've never heard before, or maybe it's stuff that you experienced long ago, but we believe that Jesus wants to meet with you right now. We believe very simply that life is better with Jesus than it is without him. And it would be wrong of us to leave this moment and not give you an opportunity to respond. So maybe you're at home and you're like, I want to experience this love. I want to experience this Jesus. Right where you're at, you can experience that. And maybe it's for the first time, or maybe it's something that you're just reintroducing yourself to after a while. But I'd love if you prayed this simple prayer after me. It says that if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, you shall be saved. And we believe that. And we're looking forward to being back. And when everything goes back to normal, we'd love if you joined us here in St. Mark's every Sunday, or if you're a teenager, every Friday night. But why don't you pray this prayer with me from wherever you're at? Maybe you're in your living room, maybe you're in your kitchen, maybe you're watching this on your phone, in your bed. And we believe that Jesus can change your life. So repeat this prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord, that you love us. I thank you that you love me. I pray right now, God, that you would forgive my sins, that you would transform my life, that you would introduce that love into my life. I pray that you would come into my heart and transform every area of my life. We believe if you prayed that prayer that Jesus has just come into your life and he is getting ready to transform your life. I'm not saying that blindly. I'm saying that because I experienced it myself. And we'd love if you connected with us. Maybe you've made that decision for the very first time. We'd love if you direct messaged us at Dublin City Youth or St. Mark's Dublin on Instagram. And we'd love to send you something we call a good news guide, which is just an introduction to a relationship with Jesus. It's very simple. It's not rules and regulations, but it's just a very simple introduction to who Jesus is and what he wants to do in your life. We're praying for you, and we're looking forward to seeing you when all of this is over. God bless.